Hello students, welcome back in our water supply lectures. Today we are going to continue with the conveyance chapter number 4, point is economical size of conveyance main. As of now we have seen the types of pumps and what are different valves are utilized with to help the pumping system. Today we are going to talk about the economic size of conveying main. First of all, what exactly the conveying main? See, this conveying main is the major pipeline which is connected to the piping systems. Whatever the water is going to flow through the selected pipe material, that will be flowing through with the help of this sufficient pressure. And to get that sufficient pressure, you need to have an economic size of that particular main. Main is nothing but main pipeline which is connected towards your pumping system. Okay, if the diameter of pumping main, that is pumping pipeline, is decreased, thereby increasing the velocity of your flow for given fixed discharge, both the friction head and the velocity head will increase, and hence the total dynamic head will increase. Now many times what is going to happen is we need to want more pressure water at the end of our consumers, and so we keep on reducing the diameter of the pipeline. But at a certain level, whenever you are going to decrease the diameter, you are going to increase the losses as well as the velocity heads over there. So total head is going to be increased if you are going to reduce the diameter. So you can't just go on reducing the diameter to achieve certain pressure. So you need to have a specific diameter, specific calculation regarding this pipeline. That's why the point is named as economic size. Economic size, that the size which is having everything taken in consideration regarding the head, regarding the pressure, and regarding the requirements of whatever our consumers are there. So that's why the name is given economic size of conveying main. Okay. This will result in increasing the cost of piping main. Okay, so again we need to consider the cost also, cost of installation, cost of complete transportation of water. So the pumping main diameter must choose in a such a way that which will minimize the pumping cost along with the annual maintenance. Such type of diameter calculation will be known as economical diameter of pumping main. So in short, what is this economic size of conveyance main is, the main pipeline should be designed in a such a fashion that whatever the diameter is there, that diameter will achieve a specific pressure which is required at the end of the distribution. It will take care about the costing as well as the maintenance system or maintenance cost of it. Okay, so clubbing together the size of diameter or the size of whatever main pipeline is there, that should be an economical one in all the aspects. Okay, I hope you understood this. Moving forward to it, what are the considerations that you need to consider while designing or taking the calculation of this economic size of conveyance main? You need to go for design period. How much of the year you want that particular pipeline to serve you, that is, the main design period is generally considered as a 30 years for one typical pumping main. Second point is different point size against different hydraulic slopes. This comes under the topography as well as whatever design you are taking along it. Different pipe material with regular cost laid, matlab what type of material you have used. Duty capacity and installation cost of pumps for the different pipe size. As the diameter varies, pressure will also varies, and to maintain that pressure you need to select such type of pumps over there. Recurring cost related to operation and maintenance cost is here. Energy charges for running the pumps, maintenance and renewal of pumps. Cost of whatever the consumables are there, that consumable cost is again included over here. The replacement of pump cost at intermediate stage. Generally, we are designing the pumps for 15 years, and whatever the pipelines are there or the other equipments are there, they are designed for the year of 30 years. So as the pumps are working 24 hours, and their open and shut cases are also there, so their lifespan is quite reduced because of this intermediate and continuous working. So their lifespan is reduced, and so the design period for pumping system we are considering at 15 years, and for throughout pipeline we are considering the design period for 30 years for calculation. Somehow the empirical formula by Lee, who have derived this formula, the main diameter you can give as a into root of Q discharged, which it's nearly with respect to discharge. So this is how you can go for the calculation and consideration of economic size of conveyance main. Now the main point that we need to consider for your examination is the stresses in pipe. Now, as you have designed the diameter and everything is going well, the water is flowing towards the consumer. Now, during this process, what are the different pressures or the stresses which will be, you know, applied naturally or artificially or because of your design on that pump that should be considered? This consideration is very important just to think about the lifespan or the design period that particular pipeline will survive, plus to maintain the pressure which is designed during the first stage of your installation that should be maintained at the last point of the survival period of that particular pipe. So there are 5 different types of stresses which will be observed on the working pipeline: internal water pressure, external water pressure, temperature, water hammer, and the stresses because of bends provided in the pipelines. So first we will go for internal water pressures. Internal water pressure is causing the hoop tension in the pipe. Now what exactly this hoop tension or hoop stresses inside the pipe? As you can see in the diagram, the internal pressure is applied on each and every internal wall of the pipeline by the flow of water. Whatever flow of water is there, it's simultaneously applying the internal pressure on every portion of the internal wall of your particular pipe. Because of that, now here sigma theta they have shown in the downward direction, and the covering whole diameter, whole circumference of your pipeline, the pressure which is applied near to the circumference of your pipeline, that is generally considered as a hoop stresses. Okay, so this stresses you can identify or formulate with the help of F is equal to P into D by 2 into T, or you can go for P into R divided by T. P is nothing but internal pressure because of water flow. D is the diameter of pipe and T is the thickness of pipe. Okay, so here hoop stresses or hoop tension is quite important, which is the causative factor to have an internal pressures. Next one, external pressures. Now these external pressures are majorly because of the overburden happened on your particular pipeline. Basically, whenever we go for any conveyance of water, our 90% of work is underground, buried in the soil. So overburden is always there on your pipeline, which should be considered as a major stress. So according to Marston, he have derived one particular formula over there, which consists CY, that is the unit weight of backfill material which is there on your pipeline. B is the width of the trench up to which you have laid your particular pipeline. C is the coefficient, which depends on the type of soil and the ratio of depth to the trench width. So C into Y B square, that will be the formula for your external pressures. Next one is temperature stresses. Generally, when many times we have seen, when we go traveling, we see the pipelines which are near to the roadways. So those are some, half of them are exposed to the atmosphere and half of them are buried underground. So whenever the pipelines are exposed to the atmosphere, there this temperature stresses has to be studied. Temperature stresses are causes in the metal pipes when they are laid above the ground. So this temperature changes, generally in the India you have in a summer seasons more than 39 degrees Celsius in the summer, which generally it's quite easy to have an expansion inside the metals which we utilize as a pipe material. So that because of this temperature elongation and somehow in a contraction in the winters, this elongation and contraction is do have the impact on the elasticity of that particular material. And if elasticity is going to vary, it means the rigidity or the durability of that particular material is going to compromise. And it will lead again the failure of that material, leakages will be there and pressure will be dropped. So you can go for the formulation that is FT temperature stresses is equal to EP, that is modulus of elasticity of that particular pipe material, alpha coefficient of thermal expansion, and theta T, that is temperature variation. So by this formula you can go for the calculation of your temperature stresses. Next stress we are going to see is water hammer, very familiar with us. Why this is happening? Whenever you have a sudden closure of the walls, which are there to have a control of flow of water inside your pipelines, if you're going to suddenly shut that particular wall, there will be an extreme motion of water in will be there, which have a stuck impact inside that particular pipeline. So this effect is produced when the velocity of pipe checks suddenly by sudden closure of valve. When valve will be closed, there will be a sudden rise in pressure. This maximum water hammer pressure pH is given by the formula that you can see on the screen. In the picture also it is seen, when the valve is closed, the water flow is quite steady. There is no much movement over there. When the valve is open, the water is flowing in its own velocity. And if the valve is closed very suddenly, the flow of water want to maintain the particular flow over there, and because of the closure it won't be maintaining that pressure, and the excess energy which is there over there because of the velocity is converted into excess pressure on the internal walls of your pipeline, and that will be considered as a hammering of that particular pipe material. Okay, so this is our water hammer stresses present in the pipeline. Next stress we are going to see is stresses because of bends. Now here two different pressures are acting, that is centrifugal force exerted by the motion of water, and second is imbalance in internal pressures. So whenever the pipe is going to have turn or the bends, the normal flow will be converted, the normal direction of flow is changed to a certain level, and because of that a centrifugal force will act on the internal walls. Plus, whatever the internal pressure is normally happening inside the walls, that will have a double impact because of this centrifugal force. And this combined action of stresses pull the pipe apart longitudinally and leads to a dislocation of a pipe. Now, whenever we have bends, we do have a joints over there, and these joints may have a dislocation because of this excess double pressure inside. So this can be given as the first, that is the imbalance, PA, internal pressure, and the area of the section where you have the particular bends. And the second one, WA, V square divided by G, this is for the centrifugal force exerted inside. Okay, so together clubbing, you can have the stresses due to the bends. Okay, so I guess here we will stop for today. So for more lectures, you can tune to the same channel. Like, do subscribe the channel for more videos related to water supply engineering. Thank you.